Hey guys, welcome in. Sat here with Jeff. In fact, take a look at Jeff. He's dressed as the scout from Team Fortress because we're doing a spooky Halloween episode. I'm playing spooky black and white zombies. What are you playing?
Spooky black and green energy.
Yeah. Spooky snakes and thieves and
nice
roll. 11. I'll go first. Now that's a mulligan.
Mine's okay.
I'll have to put on my outfit for the next video.
Obviously.
That's a mulligan.
Like, having only started at Kaladesh, it seems rather odd that in Aether of Revolt, people have like the power of planeswalkers, in the sense of like their creations they make, that they harvest the Aether.
Okay.
Where Aether seems to be like a dwelling thing. And, because you know, like there's the card Negate where it's just like all the Jaces just like disgusted by the fact that normal people can use real planeswalkers' abilities.
Yeah.
It's just like almost Kaladesh is a special plane or something where the power that makes the planeswalkers actually physical and manifestable.
Mm-hmm. Basically, the planeswalkers are just using electricity and Kaladesh has discovered it.
Six. Yeah, you just go down to five.
Five I'll keep and I'll scry.
And you start.
I'll put that away, or shall I? Leave it there. Okay, Concealed Courtyard, Dread Wanderer, go. That was a Green Belt Rampager bouncing back to hand.
Yep.
Oh, this bloody deck.
I haven't bought this box in a while. The problem with playing with hand wraps is that my hand size just doesn't fit quite right. It's just like nestling into my hand wrap.
2 damage to you.
Yep.
Pass.
Pass.
Before my time begins, I'm going to do something, but can I read this? Okay. Yeah. Okay. It's Glint Sleeve Siphoner. Before my time begins, I'm going to cycle cast out.
Okay.
Let's go to combat.
Take 2.
Mm-hmm. I will then play Plague Belcher, -1 counter here, which kills it.
Yep.
Great. 2 -1 counters through.
And in my upkeep, I'm going to lose a life and my energy, so I just draw 2. Application.
Mm-hmm.
Swing for 3.
That's got Manus right.
Yep.
I'll take three. My turn.
Yep.
Lord of the Accursed. Swing for six.
Yeah.
Go.
Aether Hub. Okay, and you're gonna counter. I'll tap one and play a Green Belt Rampager. I'll tap one and bounce a Green Belt Rampager.
Mm-hmm.
I'll tap the Aether Hub, spending an energy to make a green, and use that to bounce the Green Belt Rampager.
Mm-hmm.
I'll then tap a black and play Gondi's Machinations.
Mm-hmm.
I'll then go into combat.
Mm-hmm.
And swing for seven.
Ouch, start to turn. My turn?
Yep.
Okay, I'll go to combat for six.
Okay, taking six, down to three.
And you get an energy.
And I gain an energy and a counter.
And then I will play Plague Belcher, putting two minus ones here. And passing the turn.
Cool. I'm going to spend two energy and lose life for one extra card.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll tap one and bounce the green belt.
Mm-hmm.
I'll then tap three. Play Architect of the Untamed.
Mm-hmm.
I'll then play an Aether Hub.
Gaining an energy.
Gaining two energy because I played land and Aether Hub triggers.
Oh, yeah.
I'll then use the Aether Hub, spending an energy to make a green. Play Green Belt. I'll then go into combat with Glint Sleeve and Green Belt.
Mm-hmm.
And I gain an energy and a counter.
Okay, so the Green Belt is...
Green Belt is 7-8. Glint Sleeve Siphoner is 7-6. No, 8-6. 7-8. 8-7. 8-7, 7-8. Neither have Trample. But that has Menace.
Okay. Well, I'll gang block the big one.
Yep.
And time to reflect.
Okay. So it gets exiled.
Yeah.
And you take 7 damage.
Down to 3.
I'll then spend 2 energy, sacrificing Dante's Machination, lose 3 life, and I gain 3 life.
How much energy do you have to spend?
2.
Man, that sucks. GG. I always forget about that bastard thing.
Well, that has a secondary effect.
Yeah.
Such an underrated card, right?
Mm. It just works really well in this deck as well.
Well, it's just like, if this deck's going to use Fabrication Module, it's got to have as many one mana, like one energy triggers as possible.
Mm-hmm. Are you running four Aether Hubs in it?
Possibly. I think so.
Consulate Turret could be a good one in there.
Once again, things take up space and it's opportunity cost.
Yeah.
Like, this deck has no life gain, and it often has things which hurt me but draw me more cards.
Mm.
So it's a somewhat aggressive deck by nature. Like, it's got Glintry Siphoner and it's got Live Fast.
Okay.
And then I think it's this deck that's got the big boys. It's got Demon of Dank memes. And Aedhowyn Basker, because it's two big guns.
I'll keep this hand. I'll go first.
Because they're both situationally good.
Problem with Glintsleeve Siphoner is it dies to Fatal Push.
I'll keep.
I took my Fatal Pushes out of this deck because I wanted to use them in Modern. I barely play Modern now, so. Okay, ready?
What did you do if anyone want to play Modern with?
Classic one. One drop, Dread Wanderer, go.
Pass.
See if I can out aggro you this time. Swing for two.
Mm-hmm.
I'll play a Plains and I'll play a Festering Mummy and pass.
Pass.
Swing for three. Second main, play Cursed Minotaur. Go.
Only green. And my hand is so black. Pass.
To combat with all of them.
It's like six, right?
Yeah.
Down to nine.
I'll then play Plague Belcher and I'll kill off the Dread Wanderer.
Okay.
Go.
I lose.
Game three.
Play Green Mana. And then look at all the black things in my hand.
Should I play tonight at Commander?
Oh, no, Joe. Only tell me which deck I should play.
I know which deck you should play. I know which deck you're going to play.
The only one I have.
Yeah.
Because making a Commander deck is going to be expensive. Because it's 100 cards as opposed to 60. I think Garve is like the only viable colour if I want to run 1/1 counters as a commander. I don't know if there's any tri-colour commander which is better for 1/1 counters than him, because he at least has 1/1 counters as an effect. One mana, sack a creature.
Okay, I'll keep that.
Yeah, sure, why not? I'm gonna regret it, but I have to take it for the memes. Pass.
Dread Wanderer. Go.
You're running like eight of those, right? Swamp. Pass.
So goddamn consistent.
I consider it big draws.
Dread Wanderer. Attacking. Into Festering Mummy. Get.
This deck is rigged. Don't want to go Aether Hub? Yeah, I do want to go Aether Hub because then I want to spend all its energy. Spend the energy to make a green. Architect the Untamed.
Mm-hmm.
And then pass. 2-3 when land enters, great and get energy. Spend
yeah.
the energy to make him a 6-6 artifact beast.
Concealed courtyard, actually, does it come intact?
No.
Enters tapped unless you control two or fewer lands.
You control two.
Well, yeah, but when it enters, I'll control three.
You control two at the moment. It enters a battlefield tapped unless you control two.
Okay.
Or fewer.
Then I will do. Plague Belcher, kill off the Festering Mummy, put the one minus one counter there, and it's now a 1-2, I'll attack, go.
Tap three for Fadmoth.
Mm-hmm.
Land drop.
Why does the land drop remove its one minus one counter?
Because I get energy
yeah.
and a fab mod
oh,
puts
yeah.
a one counter on it.
Yeah.
And then pass.
To combat.
Five.
Mm-hmm.
Down 11.
Fanbearer. Cast Minotaur. Go.
Live fast. Aether Hub. So I get one, two triggers of energy. Passing.
Tap your guy. Combat.
10.
In a Keetra's name.
Okay.
Shame.
I kept the hand because it had 3 fabrication modules in it and nothing else.
Man, those zombies are pretty gross. Maybe you should sideboard in Life Goes On.
Nah.